problem we have in this world. Most people do not
realize
the things
they do.
And then they understand the
present
and they get the answer for the future. They are just confused. They are in confusion. A person is in the world. They don't know the work they have to do in this world. You should know why you are there.
Is not accident.
Your being there is not an accident. And then God said to Jeremiah, before you were born, before I created you in your mother's womb, it means that Jeremiah was created before he was born in his mother's womb. Before I created you in your mother's womb, I knew you. I sanctified you. I put you to be a
priest
unto nations. Jeremiah was created, and then he was
sanctified,
and then he was prepared to be a prophet. And then God waited. A woman and a man to get into union, and then they create a
and
then God a prophet in the
world.
And then the spirit comes.
You get it.
You understand.
You get it.
God created Jeremiah. And then he put him there to and then he waited for those to make a body. And then he sent there to come into this world. The mother and father of Jeremiah, before they got into Jeremiah was created as a prophet. He was waited to be sent into a body. And then he comes and prophesied. God has sent Jeremiah in
the
world. And then he came back. See the prophet. What is he doing? Oh, when he got
here,
Jeremiah started compromising. I'm still young. I don't know how to do. And even at the
extreme,
the one who sent him,
go
and do prophecy. But now he's compromising. And then God hearkened to his compromises. And he said, I've heard it all.
Jeremiah
1:11. And then God asked him, I've heard it all. But now, what do you see?
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Amen. For you, you were created earlier. You were created earlier. You were created earlier. Heaven knows that you're able. You don't have any excuses. Because heaven knows that you're able. When the heavens
choose the music in Uganda,
they look for who will choose. Change the music of Uganda. And then it knew it is you. But today you're showing God your illiteracy. You're showing him your weakness. You see God.
Praise God.
Mukama asimwe. I want to tell you what God sent you to do. You are able to do it. And then you are so able to do it.
Amen.
When we have a team,
Zilibiri,
and there are two, those ones praying football, and when those teams decide to pray, every team has its own members that they are sure of, that this one will score a goal, then it is so sad, the one they trust when they are caught up by fear. We are not supposed to fear.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mukamasim.
Praise the Lord.
Timu yaweyikuru.
Your team in heaven.
Nekwekakas.
It trusts you.
Nguniwarabas.
That you're able to do it.
amuzano kuyafutumireho
and to the play they sent to
yaba ni kusongora
whether it is singing
yaba ni kuragura
whether it is prophecy
yaba ni kuburra
whether it is evangelism
iyo ni kwekakasa
heaven is sure that you can do it
bwana hata chinkwe ni chimwe
what I want is
utakafa yaba tari muchai
don't mind about those who are in the field for them to stop you who is in the field Isn't that the truth?
Utakafa yo ahabatari muchai.
Don't mind about those who are not in
the field. Kuzani orekahi.
To stop you who is in the field.
Mukamasi mukamuka.
Glory be to God.
Edson Shemerinwe echikumuhendwe tumaniche.
What makes Edson Shemerinwe an apostle?
Kandi ninyoha.
And who am I?
Abamubara huriro butaba radio.
Some of you have heard of the audience in radio. When as giving
a Wao ya ora una tamba ku lift your hand.
If you're here and you have ever heard an audio talking about
Wao ya katambi.
You have ever heard about that audio?
Aniko mukono joguru joguna.
Raise up your hand straight.
Eche na tubusa sa kuba muri bachete mwaka yo kuna nisubira.
You are so little.
Kamba ze po mujurizi.
Let me first testify.
Ijo kandi vuka motoka yanje yachamuka.
Recently as driving and then my car warmed up.
So nayi perera.
And then I had to park.
Okanganda kumanya kushuka miss.
But I didn't know how I would fill it with water.
Yokanda kumakuchamuka kwayo na ile plan ya raha.
I didn't know that its warming up was a plan of God.
Ebi engineer abasa kubihakanisa.
Engineers can reject
this.
But even in the plan of God a car can
water then
I packed I wanted to put water in the
car I didn't
know how to open
it
and they had told me when you open it carelessly it burns
your hands
so I had to first park so that it
could
when I'm still parking
omukazi nomushije ari kuvuga piki ayino mwana arwire then ahitwa omukazi wenyu
there came a man who was suckling the wife and the child
then bayumera onoshuri wakana maybe amoto kumushije
the boda person knew things concerning cars
then bayumera kunyamba
ngo so they stood to help me open
omushije ari gapiki
when the man got out of the boda
omukazi ari omwana we abayino mugara kabiri
the wife looked at the child they were taking to hospital already they were bringing him at Holy Innocents hospital
hallelujah
praise the Lord
so kunare baba munonga
when I saw them cry too much
and then
in my heart I had
abashaba baba ni babasoteka ta kongorere chemba bas
I said if these people packed to help me out of grace
yoti ne chemba bazishimira
kwako then me is it there a gracious thing I can repay them
kana shasha munongo mutima
and then I was grieved in my heart
omutima gwaje gwashinda munonga
my heart grieved so much
so nadira tikangore chemba bazi
then I said let me do a gracious thing
echo kubagarura iba abandi baruka
to take them back where they were coming from
abo kwa mukaza kati ine mani ko kwato mwana
because the lady was so weak even not to handle the baby
na baragira kushita mu motoka
then I told them to enter the car
then ndina kuya kora uvuge mutwa
then I was planning after the car cools down I take them to where they were
so,
going
so kubashita mam
when they start
konka obusasi gwechibabane baza kunkora
out of the grief they had
kana nyende kuruka ngwine cishimira kubakora
I also was feeling I should do something for them
na kwato mungaro yo mwana
I caught the hand of the baby
na homa zamishi
then I closed my eyes
tikaja kunoburuhe
I can't say I was tired
konka kaura nakwishijira
but immediately I was taken in a trance
so kuna zomuturo
when I got into a trance
ati na shukari yo na rota isipeto korekwa
omurujungu it is called the trust
amen so kuna shukari kurota na rota ni ntanga tanga kana
in that very trust it was as if as mammaring the baby to come to one position
na reba de kind of nani zibo katanga tanga
I had the responsibility to keep him in
one
so that he could get back to the way he was I kept murmuring the baby
so kuka marakana kagaruka iko muryango bate
then the baby woke up and came back to the door
nasimuka
then I got out to
nasimuka nashaka kana kaburi
I thought that baby
hallelujah
amen
Praise na iyo kubanyina na iyo kubisha tibara manye lecha akorugwa hoba kanyangu ya hibuka
The father, the mother, they didn't know how the baby resurrected.
Na ba umana wawa na jato.
Again.
Ni waro tuwajiri.
They even did go to the hospital.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So nishuma rahanga.
I thank God.
Aine chokukor.
God has something to do for you.
Amen.
Echa leta kumulungu.
What has brought me here?
Edson Shemerirwe.
Edson Shemerirwe.
Uwitu akabata ryo nyichiriza mpango mbiro bya hingu iri nyumoko.
At our place we didn't have a faith.
Ejendyo niza kubaha emoni story eyabire na ngambo.
This testimony I'm giving you, it is a story that has been talked about my life.
Kandi imu kama yanga mbire kubari na leta kinjiri omosi.
And then God told me that this is a testimony that I'm bringing to the world as a gospel.
Ebe bimu kule basima ibi okutangaza manyo kuyachira ebi zibi mu kama yanga mbire kukore.
The things you see, the miracles, the healings, God did not send me to
do that. Echi yanga mbire kukore kwa iwe hinduke.
What he sent me to do is that you should change.
Oremu muhanda kwa magara gatawa.
And then you see the way of eternal life.
Ebi okuchira ebi yonga.
Healing and miracles.
No yoga kamesho.
They are just bonuses.
Kukwatika kuleto magara.
Those are the things to make you believe that you should come to
so, life. So, nkazalo kumiru kwenda chana na mwenda.
I was born in the year 1989.
Eromu shanju.
On the date of 7th.
Vyo kwa mshanju.
In the month of July.
Ombiro ebinyu maho.
In the past days.
Aha makura kwa vile ni pampa.
And to the messages they would give me.
Shwenkuru.
My grandfather.
Akwebe mbiraho church omu kampu yimpu.
He once led a church in the camp of refugees.
Mukama shimwe.
Praise the Lord.
So kuya mazile kwewe mbira church ejo.
After leading that church.
Owele mwaika.
And then time came.
Museveni abota kibabi njira banya Rwanda.
Obote had sent away the Rwandese.
So Museveni ajangu bagare.
So President Museveni said they should come.
Murage ligambe haza mtu wa.
Listen carefully to this word.
Museveni kwa ajangu bagare ke.
When Museveni said that the Rwandese should come back.
Ashwe kuri ya karichiramu.
My grandfather also came.
Ekanise yabi na ibebero mu camp.
The church he was leading in the camp of refugees. That church perished.
Abo kwa bisinjiro bakataha babweshwa.
Because those of bisinjiro went, those of who
went. Enjiro wa yabakare okumuta kabajumwa kumananyo hono twarwa.
People of long ago would get born again but they would still drink.
Nyoni chondo kwichirizo mu juru ya hatia nguno murembo gutorire.
That is why I believe in this time we are a chosen generation.
So shwenkuru kuyamazire yija ya gumaria soti agaruka mu byobuhere.
My grandfather came and then he stumbled in serving.
Koko kuyabira sinda akabaye cyera cyarugamba.
But when he would drink and get drunk and he would declare.
Akabacha kunyango echi ntara kozire omuri nyarya rgamo wachikora.
He would declare and say what I did not do out of my seed there shall come one to
you. Yazara bana.
And then he gave birth to children. And then no seed did what he was doing.
Omubijukuru.
And out of the grandchildren.
Rukumi rwenda chinano na mwenda.
In the year 1989. The day of 7th of July.
Webiro mukaga.
On the 6th day of July 1989, my grandfather had a
dream.
A star was coming upon my father's house. And then on the 7th day I was born.
Praise God.
Mukama sim.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So kuba azire byo mushanju.
When I was born on the 7th day of July.
Tata akabaraganisize mama.
My father had promised my
mother
that the day she will give up a son, they will slaughter for him. But my father did not have the very goat was when my mother said, tell him not to slaughter my goat, they had already slaughtered it.
Tata yiruka yaitishe.
And then my father ran and called
them.
And even the brethren. They should come and feast together. Because he has given birth to us. I know you people who are of age, you know those stories.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When
my grandfather came, he said he's not going to eat before he sees the baby born. When he looked at me, he was filled with joy. And then he said, this child, call him Shemerirwe. That is where I got the name
Shemerirwe.
The words he spoke, they did not take them
out of
the
spirit,
because they did not have the power to discern the spirit. I was called
Shemerirwe.
And then he said, there is a star on this child. From that day, I became a Lutheran. I became a Hooligan. I even left school. All the things
that I did,
it was a training for me to know what is in the world. If I tell you that there is no sin I've never done,
hallelujah,
amen.
Okay, come here, free me.
But that was my training.
So,
in the year 2002, my grandfather died.
Hallelujah,
amen. Before he died, the people who were in the house, he told them all to get out. He had two fingers like this. Then he called me and held my hand. And he said, my son, you have eyes that see.
Hallelujah.
I'm the person who last had his last word. By then I was
12
age. I didn't discern the words I showed. Everyone has. When I would find him in the plantation, he would be happy and he says, oh, I wouldn't discern those words. How did I come to from the year 2000? I became a lumpen that they call a super hooligan.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When I became a super hooligan, then Satan knew, now I've gotten a superman. Others look for Satan, but me, Satan looked for me. It was like at
8
night, we had
finished
as going home with all my problems. Then I met 3 men. They had other 2 men in there. One was called Arias. Another one was called
Elias.
Arias is born in
Greece,
where I'm born to.
Hallelujah.
Amen. This is a person I've ever seen with my eyes who disappears instantly.
Praise God.
Amen.
So Elias.
Elias.
Na Charles.
And Charles.
Akadarga Kabianda Charles.
Charles was coming from Kabianda.
Fwena hamwe.
All of us.
They
told us, we are taking you 3 to teach you how to get money. Then they put us in a car, Hipsam. Then they drove us
Kabianda
up to Kabianda. When we got to Kabianda, they told us the words we shall say, even the signs we shall do.
Amen.
Amen. Then we repeated the words until we mastered
them.
Then they drove us back. It was getting to midnight.
So Shamukaga tukabaturi custom naka kajera anyaj.
Immediately by midnight we were already at custom at Kajela River.
No, not custom, Kajela.
Kajela River. We sat. We started reciting the words they told us. When someone would speak
this word,
then he would sleep. Then they doze off. Me, I recited the words they had told us, but sleep didn't take me. They made me repeat the words I didn't doze. But the law was saying I should recite those words 6 times.
So,
I recited those words 6 times, but without
doing.
And these men were grieved so much. It was though they made a loss. They didn't have any joy in them.
Praise God.
Mukama Sim.
mukananye nagezeho ngo mpungira ngambe bigabeho kungambisa
I also tried to make myself doze and recite the words but sleep didn't come
abo kuba abarigire bari yashimye kuwabira uhungira ozo musendije
the area says who did it they told me when they dozed off they would get to another realm
so kuba ikirango babagira ngo bamutine ubwo umuntu uko kwita nshime era bakandi bangita nshimeriro
then they told them if you don't have that person called nshimeriro
mutine situra akore magaraka yumwe
there is nothing we can do just go back
era erutejo yarema
so that not it was a loss
bari abaka batale kupasete for free
Then those people started giving us money for free. So that we would not mama around. I had little money those days that then I was filled with joy. In that joy of like 2 months. There is a lady I used to love so much. With all my heart. That lady was called Christine.
Najel namujanta.
I went to You ladies who are here, if you are getting married because of money, you are there but you're not there.
Praise God.
Because Christine was looking money, it was like there, like a bundle. Then I married her. Within 1 month. Then they said, for us to do a firm connection with you. With their leader they were telling me about then they said I should give up my wife imagine a wife of 1 month that fresh love you have not yet quarreled no one has abused the other
nkareba Christine
I looked at Christine
narebe sente
I looked at money
narebo mukazi
I looked at
narebe sente
I looked at money
umuchika nagira ati nayanga
and then the muchika says I don't want
praise God
mukama sim
Elias saba kumanya ibono mumanyaje musa
those who know Elias for him he knows even the things I'm talking
Elias nabukira akachambuka yatasumuka zoba kweta are
In that very short time, Elias was so hot on fire. Then they told him, give up Allen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When Elias refused to give up Allen, the sacrifice caught of him. Then he cut a goat and drank its blood.
Praise God.
Amen. And then the sacrifice was still on him.
Yeah, we are.
And then he got mad. Did you see Elias mad? Who of you knows that it is true Elias got mad?
Amen.
Amen. Those who know him, they know what I'm talking about. Then immediately they called us again. When we failed to do,
Charles Way, yeah.
Charles died.
Ashigaram.
Then we remained two. I'm teaching you why am I called an apostle?
Praise God.
Mukama sim.
So Elias Pia Charles Pia Fee.
When Charles died, Elias kept mad. The problem that I had. The demons couldn't connect to me.
Hati starita kupita kadi ya matakuru
Satan cannot kill you when he's not in you.
Nimubanza mukora covenant.
You first make a covenant with Satan.
So omanyangu in the spirit nimubugabugana.
And then you understand that in the spiritual realm there is a union.
Mukama sima uno.
Praise the Lord.
Ebe nimugamba ninyenango buzi ebibuzo.
In the things I'm telling you, prepare your question. Prepare your question out of the things I'm telling you.
Elias.
In that very time, they called us again. Because as grieved in me, I said, we are going to tell the world that you people you want to take us to
Satan.
And then Elias immediately, he was well.
So,
when they understood that I'm a the trouble caused.
Batandika kureteka tego kubaranyita.
Then they started making a deal of how they can finish me up.
Byona byayangire wa Satan naremerwe.
I had failed connecting to Satan.
Warahanga ntakigo nayo ntindiyo.
Even as not with God.
Rankume.
As like there.
So batandika kureteka tega kubaranyita.
So they started making preparations of how they can kill me.
Omubirebyo.
In those days.
Kwa kitamyaho.
When we were seated there.
There was a woman who was a woman.
He has never come back again. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Najena na kumeza muka tunguru.
I went and continued to Katunguru.
Kukaka matakumanya, nguharuhu plan, ilikuza kukoko.
But I didn't know that there is a plan that is going to
happen. Awariyaha, omotora jire huka tunguru, ilizo mkono.
You are here, how many of you have ever gone to
Katunguru? Mwazora waru tindo.
You first
crossed the bridge. Ato tindo, okurumbe chisebioma. Namoku nebyo.
On the both sides of the bridge, it is made of metals.
Shaisha tuzechiro.
At 9.
Ngamanya rutinda.
As I had reached the bridge.
Abantu abenda kunyita.
People who wanted to kill me.
Bakabi namani kesente.
They had power of money.
Namani ka government.
Even the power of the government.
So nyoka tinde chindi kubale.
So me, I was nothing to fail them out.
Kupwa ichireka tungura kuse urutinda twawambuka.
When we reached to Katunguru, we crossed the
bridge.
The house we got to.
Aharinya harichwa kweta sense of wanika linga
spirit of discernment.
Yokwekengera.
In me there is a spirit of discernment.
Era nyokuna bendote chiroto naga Abraham.
Me when I would dream a dream and tell my mother.
Akaja uningungura.
He would tell me. He would tell me stop cursing
around.
When I would dream, it would happen.
Amen.
Amen.
Kukenye maho aintagamba kuna kuba bichize kuri yakagera ndende bari abanje nango nyinamisho go kuweza ndo naje kiretse nkuru yangandere kunyinamisho go kuweza.
When they got me to Kajera and these evil people told me that I have eyes that see, I remembered that declaration my grandfather.
Katandika kumanya waramisha gandi aga taryagaga.
Then I understood that there are inner eyes that are not these eyes we think.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord so
much. When
we got to the bridge, discernment came to me. Many of you, you have that discernment. But for you, you call it
ordinary.
Haven't you been walking and then you discern something and then you see a doctor? How many of you discern in your spirit? So that spirit of discernment in me, now it is
mature.
I can be here and I discern that at Coca-Cola there is an accident. All of you, you have a spirit of discernment in
you.
Your relative in America can die and then you know
what you are here.
Just because you don't understand it. That is why in me the spirit of discernment has matured. That is why I can be here. Then I discern something that is not here. Because it has matured. Amen.
So
then I discern that these people are going to
be.
I ran with food from the streets of Katunguru. When I was sloping to the bridge, these people had to stuck me in front of the
other,
and another one was behind me. Me as not a friend of water. So now I knew for me to be saved I have to fall in the sea. So I had to climb those metals there of the bridge. It was as though I'm going to drop myself in the sea.
So at kuna
na kumesa mo asiruti doko kubakotizeza pipe.
When I saw these people were looking at me, I stuck myself on the metals that were under that.
Asiruti doko atiriza abioma kuko panozerera.
I stuck myself onto the metals that were under the bridge. Under it was a sea.
Koka kuruga orai kurunaruti do then you were ya.
Up it is a bridge. Me, I was in the middle.
Hatika kuma kuasire abiome.
So I kept stacking myself on the metals of the bridge.
Chikazi kuitankisha.
After 3 minutes.
Echife chare mere mikono yatandika kuenda pole kura.
I started losing.
Omutima wanja ngwahiri ndaruka higuru banyitira higuru.
Then my heart told me, go back up.
Ndaje kusitura echife kunja ngaruka higuru omubiri gwaya.
When I tried to do that, my body was too heavy.
Kavanda chine mani kukunga rayo.
I didn't have the power to come back on top of the bridge. So I was left with one option. That metals that make that bridge. I stuck my hand in those metals. That is the scar that you see on my body. Another one it is here. Then I was like meat on a measuring
pad.
Then another one stuck in my hand here. And if these are the scars that you see.
So ndaba Kenya baiba tiramiza.
Then I was like meat that is.
Na gumani zerera ndekwire ntakubasa kuragara mumizi kandi ntakubasa garaka yiyo.
I wouldn't fall in the water and I wouldn't.
Eshaga maya rukumu mikono yashuma inamanyango yawa mumu.
And then blood oozed out of my hands. I knew that.
Abo kubandi bisi yanje mwe ningire ka fura
buso. Even my veins got problems.
So kuza iki tukamukaga zakiro.
When it got to like midnight.
Inyaje katanaka embeho yandira washongobandira mu fridge.
There was a cold breeze that got out of the sea.
Atiyoka ata kumanyangaho no ari homusamba ogwabere gukurura western Uganda yona okuba kweta rose.
Me, I didn't know that on that very place there was a demon that leads western Uganda that is called rose.
Praise God.
Amen.
So kona gomero shanka mwenda.
When I kept there and it came to the
sea. Echibiga charugo munyanje.
Then the sea had to go to the hot place.
Wena nashokuba techeregwe byo kuri.
That hot place had to cook me. It was as if I'm being cooked in a pan.
Abina mamudiyo ni ifangu ndiko bantu bagira ki
ndiko. Then I understood as dying.
Na wena abaroko.
But I didn't die.
Kubabira ndi muzakusheshesheshe.
When it was coming to morning.
Umushija inakato ari kujwe byinyanja ninkabajwe ninje.
There came a fisherman. When he saw me under the bridge, he knew I was going to commit suicide. And then he went and called other people. Then he said, lose and fall down in the water. So that water would vomit me out and then
there
is no. I would hear them, but there is no way I would
lose myself.
When they saw me keep quiet, they looked for ropes and they had to hook me up with a stick and then they pulled me out. They put me on dry land. I was paralyzed out of the coldness and even I had oozed out a lot of blood. Then they told me, when you come back to normal, tell us where you were coming from. Then they were saying, don't give him milk, don't give him
milk.
Then they started, they told me to do some physicals. When I did some little physicals, then I said, should I wait for them? Then I had to.
Think about
it. I've never gone back there. Praise the Lord. When I came back to my place, they then I even marched how they wanted to. Me, I had never believed that hell is there. Even I did believe that hell is there. Then I say, if it is to die, our mother used to sing for us a song. And he would tell us that hell will burn.
It is a must in the go.
Me, I knew it was a must to die. When it would get to a day, I would die. When it gets to night, I would know I'm going to die.
Tonight.
Do you know walking in a life of death? I lived a life of death, but as living. Praise the Lord so much.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, no, amen.
Jesus is so
powerful.
In all situations when they told me that Elias had
disappeared,
that spirit of discernment told me he was just taken.
So Najirantihati.
So I
said,
they had given us a certain fear of saying, when you get saved, you shall die. I don't know how God did for me that gracious thing. I was bypassing Father's house. When I was bypassing him, I had people clap hands. Me, I knew that in that house there was a bar. I found people starting a church. It was like a church of 5 people. When I got close there, my feet got stuck. When I got to church, my feet got stuck and I wouldn't walk. When I closed going to church, then I had to walk. I entered church. I found people I knew. They are not the ones who preached to me. Me, I just entered, I told them I want to
be.
When heaven is clear, let me enter. If it is not clear, let me fail. I entered there knowing I was going to die. When I entered, they welcomed me. They prayed for me. I was not slain. So I said, because I knew in me there was Satan, the good and the bad. Then I told the pastor, pray for me, I feel I'm about to be delivered. Because for me, I knew that when they pray for you, too many players, even some of you, that is how you know it. Then they told me, believe
me.
When it get to midnight,
overnight,
we were like 5 in church. Then they said, the overnight. For me, in my heart, I said, I want to stay with these people. When I die in people. Then they said the overnight has ended. When I understood that I was going to die, I told my wife, please go back home. Then we had to quarrel for like 2 hours out of our separation. Because she was also seeing what was happening.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So
now I was going to remain alone in the house. But these people in church told me, believe you are set free, nothing will touch you. Pastors, you know how to comfort people. I walked. Then I got to my door. I opened. Then it was opening from inside. When the door opened, it opens from inside. Then I saw a certain darkness that is not usual in my house, in my sitting room. There was a darkness that was stuck too much. Praise the Lord so much. Out of the middle of the darkness, there were 2 shining eyes like of a cat. These eyes were shining. Then I remembered that those who were praying for me, they were saying that in the name of Jesus. Then I also got hold of
my hands.
Before I got the name Jesus, out of the fingers, there is a power that came out of it and it filled the house with
that.
This power had to strike me. Every part of my body was broken down. When I was going to fall down, then I started seeing what was going to kill me.
nareba chine feselinke yo muichi.
Then I looked at it, it had a face that was like of a god.
Amishugarikaga akapa.
Then the eyes were like that of a cat.
Amatugarikaga akapa.
The ears were like those of a cat.
Tande chiromukunde ari komuichi abana miramba be.
Starting from the umbilical cord, it was like a lady who is
getting. Then
the upper side, he was a, like a young lady.
Umukunde
developing breasts.
Umukunde kegejoka mpango yezinjira musiki rumwe.
Starting from the umbilical cord, it was like a snake. It was seated in my sitting room and seeing me. But by then, out of the power that struck me as
laying.
And then a voice that was so tough. It spoke to me and said, I chose you to do work for me. Now choose. You either come back to me or I kill you. Then I said, even if I say yes, I will die. When I say no, I will even die too. So I was filled with death. I refused. Out of me refusing, I did not speak
a word.
When you refuse in your heart, in the spiritual realm, when you refuse in your heart, in the spirit, it is a word that's
said.
What you think in the spirit. When you think something in the spirit, that is why the Bible says he will judge people even in their thoughts.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Now this very thing got a sword out of it. It was going to stab my spirit.
Is it so?
This sword, I want to tell you, some of you, you dream and then you don't put
it,
but dreams, some of them have reasons as to why. When you're here and you dream a dream, seeing a cat. Cats represent
demons.
Then when you dream a snake, that is when you dream cows, those are. You can dream a dream someone stabbing you with an axe. If someone doesn't stab you with that
axe,
that means there is a grace that is stabbing you. But when you dream that you have been stuck with
that axe,
you start having headache from that instant until you die. When you dream someone stabbing you with a sword in the
throat,
then you will get stomach pains
from
them. Many people get sickness
in the service.
Those diseases come out of people dreaming have spiritual affairs with spiritual men. They brought for me a child dressing. Many of you, you know that before I pray for you, I ask, what dream did you
have?
Because it doesn't, the problem, everything that touches the flesh, it comes from the spirit. I was praying for a kid when I put my hand like this on him. And then God told me, this person dreamt falling in a pit. And when he fell in that pit, are you here?
Yes, Ariaha na mama we.
Bring that kid to me.
Praise God.
Mukama simwe.
Are you mutuona jirokushabili sinji?
There is someone I want to pray for in his
life.
This person was lame for 4 years. This person wouldn't stand.
Praise God.
So, just because this person couldn't stand, he dreamt becoming lame. Indeed, he became lame. When as minister, I told people to stand.
Atuwe ya gumashitam.
For him, he kept sitting.
So na bajirangu aye mwemeremwena.
Then I said, all of you stand. Then they told me his name. Then I said, in the name of Jesus, stand. You got sick in a dream. May God make you stand. And that woman had to stand in the name of Jesus.
So
they brought for me this child recently. What I've told you, even when I ask him, he can tell you.
Mukama simwe ninyenda kugubagana ni wachiroto ukaroto rukumuchi yes ukaba inogwa babwinji muno kandi wagwe warebe chikuruka
you see what comes out of
akaroto ari kugwa yo
he dreamed holy
chiroto chisha oroto rukusa kugwa mukonga tokujirota
some of you dream falling in pits, but you're not falling. This one dreamt falling in a dream. That is why he became lame. The problem is not a dream. But those who woke up to fight him, they overpowered him. And then it happened to him. When you dream a dream, that a car has stuck you
out.
You should at least dream that it wanted to knock you. There you are.
Victory.
But when you dream that it has knocked you, you have failed already.
So,
make this person sit somewhere else. Then I end up my message.
Praise God.
Mukama simwe.
Yes.
This one is a grandson to the vice king of Ankole.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So which is it?
Listen to this. Every dream you dream. Some of you dream walking on water. I'm going to have a day and teach you about
it.
These evil people these people of
Illuminati,
these people who sacrifice
others,
they use a system. They pull your spirit and then they do their things on your spirit. Because they know a thing that is done in the spirit, it has to manifest in flesh.
You get it?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So,
now when this demon got the sword wanting to stab me, then I had a certain voice telling me three times. Then it was telling me, repent, I come near to you. Repent, I come near to you. This person that was telling me those words, but it was a voice full of grace, more than the grace I've ever seen or heard. Even the grace of my
mother,
the grace that was in the voice that was talking, I was feeling a certain grace, a grace that is greater than all the graces. You must be here saying that you
are.
There is someone who has. There is that one who gave up. This person wanted to touch me, but just because I was dirty, and yet for him he can't come close to sin, he was telling me, repent. When I said, oh God, forgive me, what wanted to kill me with a sword in its hands, I looked for it, I couldn't see it. When I looked for it and couldn't see it, then there came the hardest phase. In only 7 seconds, I was filled with hotness, like a person cooked upon a pan. Then I had to. Amen.
So kuna isikire mu munonga.
Hallelujah.
Kuna isikire mu munonga umutima gwacu beka mu kabiri.
Then my heart was divided into parts.
Ataho nahura narekura umurinye naza mwa bantu babiri bakushikira.
Then I felt two people in me and I dozed off.
Nahuro kuguru ni kushushoko mu kuguru.
Then I had my own foot getting out of my leg. And the leg got out of my leg. And another ear got out of my ear. Another eye got out of my eye. Even out of my teeth got out other teeth. Then I had another me struggling to get out of me. I felt like a whirlwind getting out of me. The very copy that got out of me. It was exactly me. Me, when I wanted to see Kampala, I would see there. But I saw we were two. Me who is thinking
about here.
And this one that you see, I was like there. I kept looking at my body. I looked at my body, it was like a box. Even though you told me to get back to it, I wouldn't. Then I was there full of confusion. The same voice that told me repent came back. Actually, see it because you have to listen to this.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When this voice came back, it said, follow me. Then it told me we are out of the world of the flesh. Now we have entered the world of the spirit. This world we go to, there was a valley of darkness. Let me repeat this. I'm not dreaming, I'm telling you realities. This world we go to, there was a valley that divided us. But it was so deep in there. And the voice told me, even though they make you fall in it for 1,000 years, you will not get to its end. And then it told me, this is the valley that separates hell from heaven. So that those in heaven should not get hell, and those in hell should not get hell. And then the voice told me, see at your left hand. When I looked at my left hand, then I saw a lake so big. It was full of fire. In that lake there were people I knew and those I don't
know.
When they saw me, like the area says, and others, they started flattering me with joy. They knew as going to where they are. When they were still in joy, me, I had not yet reached hell. But fire burnt me. And then fire burnt me even when I had not reached hell.
Let me tell you,
this burning is greater than the burning you know. May God reveal this to you. This burning in hell, it is the burning that is greater than the burning in this world.
So kuna urinata kamunonga.
Then I had to scream aloud. And then the same voice told me, raise up your eyes and turn to your right. How many of you have ever seen a playground of football on TV? There was a certain world that is like a beautiful playground. Everything that was there, it had peace in it. And it had wisdom. Even the grass had understanding. Please forgive me. These things are like foolishness in wisdom.
Praise God.
Mukama sim.
So kuna agomirene nde message.
When I kept staring
at this
peace.
Nena nikubo kujango marika Gabrieli na Mikiri.
Peace and sadness, there are things that are touchable and seen.
Chihine chihine chihine.
There is nothing that has a name that is not the
king.
Even peace is one of the things that are created but you can't see
it.
Because when I see the spiritual realm and I
see
everyone that sits there, then that peace welcomes you like an usher. And peace had to welcome you. Peace came when I was looking at
you.
Because that's also a spirit.
And
that peace was also a spirit.
Wow.
And then peace entered me. When peace entered me, I also entered the realm of peace. This world we are in. Then this very world came before me as a screen. Then I looked at people with bangers,
axes.
One would kill another because of a wife, confusion. And then the voice told me, I want you to go back there. I never wanted to come back. Because I felt I was in a
place that
I looked at
it,
I knew it was like a burden. Just so what?
Praise God.
Me, I don't even desire to be
honored.
That is why many people have come to me and told me, you do miracles, you do things, why can't you make an office? When you give the glory to God, that means I also
praise
have
a God.
Glory.
Amen.
When I'm still in that joy and
peace,
that is the reason. The Bible says
to
the
man,
Ephesians,
you
shall be free indeed. There is a peace that a poor man, when he gets that peace, he feels
he's
justified. He's okay. If you don't have this peace, even when you have a car, you feel you have a burden. I looked at this peace with my open eyes. If you get blessed and someone tells you how to
peace,
receive that peace with joy. The problem we have when someone
says,
you look at it as just something. When the Son of Man shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. Peace is there. Then I had to look left and right. There is one word I speak out with boldness. The fact that you're created, I believe you will see this glory. And what is this word? That is the word of grieving. I was still in that peace. Then another voice spoke so loud. And then it said, know it from today. When I'm speaking about these things, they come back to me. I speak out of vision. Then the voice told me, know it so well, that the books are going to be opened. But the voice that spoke those words, it spoke with authority. Authority that has no grace in it.
Praise God.
Mukama sing. Is there someone understanding? The Bible says someone declares with his mouth, then they receive salvation. If you don't confess when you still have a mouth, then you will never get another chance to confess. That the books are going to be opened. Where we shall find your name, that is where you're going to go. You have seen hell and you have tasted it. You have seen heaven and you have tasted it. If it is you, what
do you do?
Think about that. If it was you, bring these things before you. May God reveal these things before you. Then you're looking at these things. You don't have what to do, whether a yes or a no. And wherever you shall go, that is where you're going to spend all your days. The days that are not like the days of this world. Everything that I had done in my life, I remembered everything I had done in just like 2 seconds. Then I was seeing those who were in hell, I was even worse than them. Immediately, now all the two realms came before me. Now I was in the middle. I'm not in hell, I'm not in heaven. Then I came back to this valley that separates the two realms.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord so much. Then I came back to this point that divides the two realms. Then out of the fire came a tall giant that had teeth like of a forked hole. Then this person had a tail that was like a snake. Then it had tall fingers. And then it had angels by the sides. Then this giant came unto a tall table. This table had maggots on it, but these maggots were not burning. Then the angels got hold of a book. The angels of that giant. Then this giant started opening the book, looking for my name.
We are natural.
Then out of heaven also came another person who was shining like the morning sun. When this person came out of heaven, when he appeared, everything, even those in hell, bowed down and worshipped him. Even hell worships Jesus. I saw everything worshipping. Immediately, the angels that came with Jesus got hold of us all white book. The book that was with the angel of Satan was so big. But this small book that Jesus had was very small, but desirable to look at. And then Jesus also started looking for my name. Then when Satan got to where my name was written, he was full of wrath. He was full of wrath. Then the voice told me the reason as to why he's filled with wrath. That last night, When you confess to
prayer,
saying that, oh Jesus, write my names from the book of
discretion
and write them in the book of life. Your name was
practiced.
Then your name is that the son of the king has. And then Jesus, that your name is written here, but your names have that in them. Go back to the world, and then you do what you had not yet done. That is how I resurrected. Everything that I've told you about happened in only 3 hours in that death. And then many people talked. Then they said, he didn't go with those of the sea, now he's dead. I resurrected when I was so weak, and I kept weak for like 1 week. How many of you heard about it and you're here?
Glory
is there, cancer is there. Those are the people who witnessed that. That was my death. Those are the things I saw. That is what makes me an apostle. That's what makes me an apostle in this world. I don't want to preach to you anything. Even I don't want to pray anything for you. But only one thing. If someone gives me 100 million and they don't get saved, then I feel I've done nothing. Me, I'm filled with joy when someone gets saved more than I get. The miracles I've done are enough to make me big, but I'm not big because of miracles. Wow. One thing I want for you to know, the one who died for you. When you know that, my heart shall be filled with joy. When I'm preaching the gospel, it is as if I'm carrying something. These words that you have heard, God told me to put them in a testimony to preach about them. We are even going to do a filling out of them. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We are even going to write about them. Me, I know that is the reason as to why I'm there. Praise Jesus. There are things that have come to tempt me. Someone comes, then he says, Pastor, I want to come and
pray.
Someone called me, Pastor, I'm coming for you to pray for. Then he said, I'm coming. What kind of an envelope should I come with? Then I asked, why is the world so wicked to that point? Instead of someone coming before God with an envelope of his heart, they want to come with an envelope of
his.
Do you think God is so greedy to want your money?
Praise God.
Oh, come and sing.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let me stop there. Then I teach on the purpose of blood. I'm going to teach about blood. When we are ending, before I end, I want to talk about blood. The Bible says that our forefathers sinned and they are not
here.
And it is us that are carrying their sins. Now, don't think that you have those things in a bag or in a sack, no. And then he says, I'm going to confront your children over the sins for four generations.
No man, yeah, watch.
Do you know why? The first, second, third, and fourth generations have a connection to someone who is living. And in the spiritual realm, when someone dies today, he immediately becomes a spirit. Then he grows up. What they call a demon.
No more you in the capacity to put on Mutu Tina Uzari. I come to Jazza Pemusa, but I almost let me a quick Kumutuao a fee.
For someone to be a demon, that means they have a capacity to attack even people that they are not related to. Intercessors
who are here.
You need to be filled and filled with power. Don't just cast out a demon and you think you are
dead.
There is a demon, you will say fire, it answers fire
too.
Because they
are
bandit in Ntungamo, China, everywhere. For a spirit to become a demon, that means it has been burnt and fire can't burn it. For you, you need to know the blood of
Jesus.
The blood
there
is no stone that turns and changes. Fire can burn. But the blood of Jesus changes covenants. If you are in the Jesus, we put you to a covenant that is not
known.
That is why in my prayers I make a lead of the blood of Jesus. Many of you, you do not know what
Eshagama
is. What is blood?
Eshagama.
Blood
Nechume.
Is one of the things. Blood is a mediator unto flesh and the spirit. Why the body gets to the spirit? The mediator there is blood. The Bible says, never eat an animal with its life. Life is blood. Did you know that life is in blood? Let's get to the scriptures. If you have not brought where to write, those are your problems.
Praise God!
You come and see me.
Praise God!
You come and see me. Let's get to the book of Leviticus. Fire cannot make you a chosen generation. Even fire cannot get out of you of the genealogies.
You need the blood of Jesus.
But the demons that are in chains can
because
demons they walk in
blood.
So blood washes blood. Let's get to the Leviticus. Leviticus 17:11.
Yesu mukwano gwange